I am Dr. Bala Bhaskar, Professor Bala Bhaskar from India. I am the president of our association, Indian Society of Anesthesiologists. So must be almost 28 years in the field. One difference which I can say, challenge I can say is, we are the only medical professionals who probably deal with the patient's life directly, unlike other specialists. So changes happen very fast in a patient's condition, and anesthesiologists are the specialists who are the ones who are well trained to see that the patient recovers and the patient lives also after major surgeries, cardiac arrest and other dangerous events. And as I say, since 1990s, we are now getting more and more monitors to see that the patient is managed safely. One of the major problems in medical field is human errors causing complications and death. So this has happened across the world, and our society and World Health Organization, everybody has protocols intended to reduce the risk of error. So error has come down drastically, so number of lives saved has also increased drastically, but we are not able to bring down the human errors to below certain level. So at this point the monitors come into play. So various clinical monitors, patient monitors, including pulse oximetry, ECG monitor, advanced monitors, they have definitely helped in improving the patient outcomes and safety. So what I can say is, we can divide them into some advances in anesthesia delivery and advances in monitoring. Advances in delivery of anesthesia means we have got better anesthesia machines, workstations. We have got more and safer, newer drugs. Anesthesia drugs, newer agents, so they are more safe to use, and the anesthesia machines are also technologically more advanced, so they give us alarms whenever something goes wrong, and we are able to see that some mistakes are corrected and patient is managed successfully. Secondly, about monitoring, before operation, during the operation and after the operation also, we have got new technologies and new monitors. So there are improvements in pulse oximetry, improvement in most importantly assessing the depth of anesthesia. We call them as entropy, BIS and other things. Plus we have got advances in terms of using point of care devices. So all these have helped us to bring down the what we call as morbidity and mortality in medical terms. So when I, as I told you, in terms of machines, so what is important is certain safety features to be incorporated. So machine should allow, for example, a minimum flow of oxygen to the patient, below which patient will be in danger. So that option should be available in anesthesia machines, so that patient doesn't suffer from what we call as hypoxia. That is very important. And whatever we administer, the, for example, for anesthetic agents, inhalation agents, we should monitor how much is going into the patient and how much is coming out of the patient. So we call them as end-tidal anesthetic gas concentration. So that is very important, and we should assess the depth of anesthesia in the patient with various monitors and balance for a particular patient. Yeah, I have been using probably since 2010, so when initially that VATO 65 model was released. Our institute in south of India, we purchased about 5 machines those days. Now after that model, I have seen improvements in the machine and the monitors. For example, when I was there 2 days ago in Shenzhen, when I watched the new models demonstration, I think A9 machine was there. It has incorporated lot of additional benefits, which will help in patient safety. And the company also has added some intelligent algorithms within the system, suitable for assessing the outcomes. For example, in patients with sepsis, patients for daycare procedures, they are all part of the machine algorithm. But if I am an anesthetist, I am an intensivist, I can go inside, I can enter data for a patient, not just the anesthesia parameters, I can enter other parameters from the laboratory and I can grade the patient's outcome. So that additional feature will help the practitioners. And one more addition I found was about the high flow nasal cannula. That is a useful addition for patient management. And of course, there is an alternate pressure analyzer that was also explained to me. That is a good future. So probably I think we should put it into use and see how beneficial it is for the patient. The Western world has advanced already and they are looking into the next level of development. Whereas in countries like ours and China, as I told you before, we have to pull up some of the institutions in the periphery, in the smaller places to certain level. But what I foresee is simultaneous improvement in the major hospitals and improvements in smaller hospitals also. So development could be in the form of data sharing, patient data. You can sit here and you can look at the database. They all form part of what is called as Internet of Medical Things. I don't know whether you have heard about it. There is what is known as Internet of Things, where artificial intelligence and virtual reality and data collection networking come. When we specifically talk about medical field, it is called Internet of Medical Things. So that is going to be the future. Invest. And within the next 5 years in China and India also. So we will have patient data available everywhere. And that is going to guide patient management even in remote areas. You need not go to remote areas. We can know what is happening. We can advise treatment and patients can be managed better. So this is the future and all the monitors will be remotely controlled. Our brain cannot improve beyond certain limit. So then the medical companies will come into play. They will create more and more algorithms based upon our requirements, incorporate the algorithm into the software of the device, and that will create an artificial intelligence for us. So we need definitely participation and contribution from the devices industry so that we are able to manage large patient population in countries like ours and China, and you will save time and you will save money also for the government. And of course for poor patients. So this is the future and everything will be in the cloud storage. So we can access anybody, anywhere in our own countries. That's the future.